7 days a week, up to 12 hours a day, it's all go for beauticians and barbers.
If someone phoned up today, they wouldn't be able to get a booking for 7 days. And we've never experienced that before.
Desperation is a little bit out there, but there's also been, quite surprisingly, a lot of people who are booking in for your relaxation, facials.
And that shows in a snapshot of retail spending data from Paymark, a 61% jump in spending on beauty and hairdressing since the same time last year. And as we moved from alert level 4 to 3 to 2...
Takeaway food, liquor, electronics and garden centres have all seen cards swiping, up 30%. Pharmacies and veggie stores have also seen a boost, up 27%. But there are still some big groups struggling. Restaurants, clothing and motels, all down 7%.
They really are struggling to see their revenue come through. So hopefully once we move further in through level 2 and on into level 1, we'll start to see that come back to life again.
While the good times roll for some, they're also worried about what will happen in a few weeks' time.
We're very busy now, but are we going to be busy? We don't know.
The dead cat lands and it bounces. Oh, everything's good. And then, yeah, July, June and July, we're optimistic, but generally I think there's going to be a downturn.
In a pledge to support small businesses, banks are promising to pay their bills within 14 days. And the Reserve Bank's opened up about its job to keep interest rates low to help the economy.
There's nothing untoward about it. It's what central banks do on a daily basis, and we have done for many years, decades even. It's just that all of a sudden we're doing it in much larger quantities. It grabs all the headline.
So while the Reserve Bank's doing its bit and we're doing ours...
And so much uncertainty about what the future's looking like that really we're just taking month by month.
Many more haircuts and waxes are needed to get the economy pumping. Katie Bradford, One News.